Of the Son of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Happy feast day.
Happy feast day.
By this sign conquer. This is what Constantine hears and sees written in the sky as he goes to face his adversaries, the Milvian Bridge. Little did he know what that encounter with God was going to mean for him. He went there with his army, of course, with the other army that had been quite successful to this point, trying to defeat the people that were greatly persecuting the Christians. Constantine was trying to, of course, put a stop to some of this, but he had not quite had that encounter with God yet. And he also did not quite believe yet until he saw the Lord himself tell him that this is what he was to do, to put the symbol on his weapons, to put the image of the cross up before the army going into battle. But that would be the sign by which he would achieve victory. And of course, we know historically that he did achieve a great victory that day. And after this, began his conversion process to become a Christian. It wasn't in power. Yes, it was in a type of power, but not the type of power that Constantine had had before, not in a worldly power that Constantine was able to conquer. It was in the humility of Christ and the strength of the gospel. Because Constantine greatly began to change his life at this point, and the laws of the land began to change radically, ways that the pagan society had never seen, and of course Christians were granted great toleration. Only a few centuries later, the Emperor Heraclius, after the cross had been taken off to Persia, was able to gain victory and bring the cross back to Jerusalem, the true cross. And he tried to bring it in, of course, in great fanfare, much as Constantine had defeated his enemies with, and a hidden power would not allow him to enter into the holy city. Because, of course, he was dressed as the emperor and desired to bring it in with great, great pomp. And that was not allowed. The patriarch tells him to remove those robes that are dressed simply, to walk in humbly as the Savior bore his cross. And there, Heraclius brings in the cross, is allowed to come in that way, because that is the way we will conquer. It's by that sign we will conquer, by the cross of humility. The Holy Fathers, in particular, thinking of, I was reading yesterday, where one said that the cross was the Father's will, was the glory of the Son, and was the rejoicing of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Trinity takes part in this cross because they are always united and not divided. And in the cross, they came to us to teach us to achieve the way to salvation, which only Christ could really truly accomplish with us, was the means by which we would attain to salvation. In the Garden of Paradise, we lost our salvation through a tree by eating the tree of good knowledge. By the tree of Golgotha, we gained our salvation. By wood, we were saved. By a virgin in Paradise who had not yet bore a child, Eve, we lost our salvation. By a virgin, many centuries later, we gained our salvation by Christ coming through her. By a tree, we lost our salvation. By a tree, we gained our salvation. And by death, we lost salvation and lost that connection with God. But by the death of the Savior, we gained salvation. So these things come back on themselves and turn back on themselves. And it's only in this way we can gain salvation. We have to realize this image that we wear, as we've said so many times, is not the beautiful image of glory that we always portray it. It was an image of destruction, an image of great pain and torment that Pontius Pilate in particular used to kill many, and many other, of course, rulers did as well in that time period. Of course, it goes on to our own day in some quarters of the world. But the cross was an instrument of fear for people, and all of a sudden you have people walking around the world making the sign of the cross upon themselves and wearing emblems of the cross on their bodies and proclaiming victory in the cross. It seems absurd to the world. It certainly is foolish to the Greeks and a stumbling block to the Jews. It makes no sense. But yet it is the way we gain salvation. Pain is the common language of man, and that pain, we can transfigure pain. Pain is no longer empty and absurd. The pain that we have in our lives is filled up by meaning and bearing the cross of Christ. And this contrast, of course, of life is very stark. Because if you look at the image of the apostles, especially in the Gospel of Matthew, when they are called to follow, they don't sit there and ponder the consequences. They don't quite understand what any of this means yet. Quite, they make many mistakes. But that encounter with Christ makes them go immediately, as they will learn much more about it later, as did Constantine. We are called from the cross too with that same message. Christ sits on the cross to this day, filling up that cross and saying, come follow me. Come follow me. And we don't have the time as the rich young ruler to sit there and calculate, okay, if I do this, my comfort zone is going to be shattered and it's not going to be very easy in life anymore. I'm not going to have all the pleasures that I like. We must do as the apostles and immediately leave our jobs, leave our livelihoods, leave our families, leave everything we know, if he calls us to follow Christ. So when we are sitting in our daily lives, just sitting back constantly in comfort and eating delicacies and watching, constantly entertaining ourselves, but not changing our hearts, we must realize Christ called us to a cross. Only he who renounces his life will gain salvation. He who hates his life in this world will be saved, the Lord tells us rather starkly. He is calling us to change, and this exaltation of the cross should tell us that. The cross is not an instrument, as Elder Joseph would say, of the devil throwing marshmallows at us. It entails throwing fiery darts at us. And we can sustain those things by that shield of the cross, which we can bear in our lives. So, brothers and sisters, the Lord tells you this day to take up your cross. But that is not something to fear. It is something to rejoice in, because by this sign, Christ conquered death, sin, and the devil. By this sign, Christ conquered the world. By this sign, Christ elevated us to paradise. And by this sign, Christ continues to save us to this day. So take up your cross and come and follow Christ. Amen.